Welcome to my channel, dear Technical Gyan. Myself Devabrot Roy. Let's begin to understand that we should not afford these 10 mistakes during root cause analysis and investigations. Root cause analysis, 10 common problems during investigation. You might think you have done enough root cause analysis, that they are old hat by new and you can just cruise through the process. If so, you are probably making common mistakes that create inconclusive analysis that falls short of addressing the problem. Number 1. Lacking of enough root cause analysis. The biggest mistake with RCA is that people don't do enough of them. Because an RCA takes resources, people are reluctant to initiate an RCA, and then they end up having a more severe event later on that could have been prevented if they had done the RCA on a near miss or a pattern of near miss. Number 2. Short-staffed during RCA. When a situation comes to your attention, there should be a discussion among the risk manager and other senior leaders about whether an RCA would be valuable. Often that discussion doesn't occur, or if it does, you don't have any objective criteria to base a discussion on. Organizations often attempt to do an RCA with only one or two people instead of as a team. Sometimes adequate number of staffs did not deput to perform the investigation. Inadequate management of short-staffed while doing investigation is a biggest mistake. Interviewing them is not a good substitute because they feel intimidated and end up just answering your specific questions. You need them to participate so that they relate what they know. You will miss variation from the process and the real-world practices that people build in to make up for these shortfalls. Attending RCA team meeting, brainstorming session is very important. Sometimes the core members provide excuse to escape from these meetings. So every meeting should be attended by all the core members and they should brainstorm together. Number 3. Avoidance of flowchart the process. People tend to avoid flowcharting during an RCA because it is tedious. But you should do it always. It's a nuisance, but the visual display really helps people more than just stating the sequence of events. Ask question between these two blocks. Is there anything else that happens? If you are skipping steps, you are missing possible sources of variation. Number 4. Focusing too much on a single cause and escaping other root causes. The name of the root cause analysis implies, intentionally or not, you are trying to find one single cause. That's really the cause. We should focus more on contributory causes. It's more likely a number of factors that come together, not just one huge thing. Look for the multiple things that increased the likelihood of this happening. Number 5. Insufficient barrier analysis. A good RCA should include time spent brainstorming on what barriers should have prevented or minimized the impact of the incident. The barrier can be physical, or a policy or procedure that should have prevented the bad outcome. Most people do barrier analysis, but they don't do enough. Number 6. Not defining the problem statement correctly. Problem analysis be conducted prior to beginning a root cause analysis. This will not only determine whether a problem truly exists or is just perceived, but will also identify where the problem exists, when it exists, and how pervasive it actually is. A well-defined problem statement drives the entire root cause analysis correctly. Number 7. Improper root cause validation. When conducting a root cause analysis, resources familiar with the problem's issue are utilized to create the fishbone diagram. However, each root cause identified in the diagram is actually a potential root cause. A hypothesis per se as fishbone diagram is created based upon experiences of the resources and not data. Each identified root cause must have a validation plan to determine if this hypothesis is true or false. Number 8. Not sticking to the root causes. The fishbone diagram uses the 5 why techniques within its model. Asking why 5 times or until no longer actionable identifies potential root causes. The end of this trail of questions is where the potential root cause lies. Many times, important teams revert back to the beginning of the 5-why questions in selecting potential causes, thereby passing up to the root cause altogether. Number 9. Conclusion with lack of training, support or money as root causes. The lack of training, leadership or management support or funding are not root causes to the organizational or operational problems. They are solutions. The causes of the problem lie elsewhere. Never conclude them as the potential cause. Actual reason for lacking of these resources need to be identified, and adequate kappa should be derived immediately. Number 10. Not spreading the word of what you learn. Often the people who learn the most from the RCA are the ones in the units where that incident occurred, which sounds fine at the first. An RCA should be much more useful to the organization as a whole. Too often, there is no mechanism for providing that information to others in the organization. So, these were the common 10 mistakes we performed during our root cause analysis. We should learn on them and get experienced enough so that we will not make these mistakes in our daily life again, and make our investigations perfect from all aspects. So if you like my video, then please press the like button, share it. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that you will get notification of every new updates. So please be safe, stay safe, and always be happy. Thank you.